up, y'all? It's the Majinai, and it's time for another one. So today we got a few things to cover. I usually don't like putting a whole bunch of things into one vid, but it's just so much things happening all at one time. I just want to get it all out of the park now because I actually did go see Fighting with my family, and I want to do a review for that. So I don't want to take up too much of my time with the stuff that's... I mean, it is important stuff that's been going on, but... you know, I just want to condense everything. So, whatever. Let's get into this real quick. So, we got a couple things. And as you can see from my thumbnail, we're going to be talking about a little bit about Alita and a little bit about Captain Marvel. But let's go into... We actually got a couple articles here in regards to Alita, and then we will discuss those. And as usual, I will have everything in the description so you can check it out. But anyway, the first article we have here is from CBR.com. And this is Alita Battle Angel underscores Hollywood's whitewashing problem. And this is by Ronaldo Medardine. So with this going on, we've heard this before, you know, as far as like with things with Ghost in the Shell, even they bring up Tilda Swinton and Doctor Strange, I went blank on the name of Doctor Strange, and all the stuff like that. And for them bringing up the part with Alita, it's just like they can't leave Alita alone for some reason. Like the crazy thing about it is that it's doing very well over in our Asian family across the water. It's doing well over there with them, and for some reason, the thing that gets me is that we have certain types of people, they have to be upset and outraged for whatever culture that they feel they need to be upset and outraged for, which is kind of weird. But I want to take out something from this article real quick that I pulled out from the article, and I want to just read that for you real quick, and then I'll discuss a little bit more. So the manga creator Yukiro Kishiro did praise the film, talk about Alita, just like the Ghost in the Shell creator, Shihiro. And that's fine. We understand. To these creators, it's up to the studios to subvert the material as they see fit. After all, the original version still exists, no matter what happens with the live-action adaptations. But the kind of mentality that leads to removing the source material's Asian influence leaves a portion of the audience feeling like they are being sold short, or worse, excluded. So my thing is, who's feeling excluded? And did you actually watch this movie? Because they clearly say in the movie that this is the last place on Earth where civilization basically, I mean, you're going to have like people scattered about, but it's like they say everybody kind of migrated to Iron City and the Floating City in that area. So basically everybody's in the same spot. So it would make sense that not everybody would be, you know, Asian or Japanese or wherever they're from. It would be people from everywhere. But the crazy thing about it is that if you see the OVA, Dr. Ito and his wife that was in there, Jennifer Connelly was playing, have blue eyes and blonde hair, even though I believe that the other doctor was not in the manga, but that's neither here nor there. I've never actually read them. I just recently saw the OVA. So the OVA is the direct comparison I have to this movie. They are, and if you actually watch manga or even the animes, 9 times out of 10, when they have a character that is have blue eyes and blonde hair, they traditionally saying that that person is a Westerner. That's usually how it is. I forget what I was reading some manga actually that the person that was drawn with the blonde hair was actually called an American. So that's just how they draw them in that case. Now, of course, they're saying that, you know, Alita is meant to not necessarily be of any race. She's an android. And what race is an android? Android is an android. So it doesn't make a difference what part of the world that android was created, and androids could be an android. It doesn't have a race. It's an android. So, I mean, it just makes me a little crazy that we gotta have that. And again, my thing is, who is feeling excluded? From, like I said, over in China and on the other parts of the world, this movie's doing well. It's just here it isn't, which is funny that rather than trying to boost this movie up to get more sales here, it seems like every article I see about this movie is pushing it down. More to the point, let's go to the next article. And this is from R29, so Refine29 Review. And this one, this one is Alita Battle Angel is Man's Fantasy of a Powerful Woman. And this is written by Ann Cohen. And yeah. So this is another thing where, like the previous video I put up where, you know, it talked about Alita being over-sexualized. This taps into that a little bit, but it's a little crazy how, again, now this is a female writing this article. We're putting down the characters in the movie for what? Especially when, again, Alita is supposed to be an android. And the reason they kept the big eyes on her is just to keep kind of true to the manga / OVA. That's why that's there. It's not supposed to be about male gaze. And she brings up, oh, she has curves in here. Again, with the curves. Alita's character is CGI. Even the actress, and I mentioned this before, the actress Rosa Salazar said that the character is not over-sexualized. So if the person who's playing this does not feel any kind of way about how the character is, why are you feeling that way? Why? What is it? Again, it just seems like it's kind of crazy to me that we got to constantly keep pushing this movie down. When, again, like I said before, I would love to be sitting here talking about how great this movie is, and I have to talk about how bad things are going with it. It's just crazy. But anyway, let's talk about what she wrote here real quick, and I'll discuss that a little bit more also. So, she actually starts the article out with, I wish Alita Battle Angel had been made by a woman. The cyberpunk action film inspired by Yukito Kishiro's manga Ganon could have been a game changer in the way women, and specifically teenage girls, are portrayed on screen. A bounty hunter cyborg with the power to bring down toxic masculinity. Sign me up. Let me stop right there real quick. What is it with this whole thing where it's got to be against people? Like, yeah, are there, you know, your quote-unquote douchebags out there? Who are guys? There's douchebags out there that are females too. Do you talk about the toxic femininity? Does anybody talk about that? No. Why? I wonder why that is. Because what ends up happening, like I said before, you don't make things better by saying, oh, I have the power now, so I'm going to treat you the same way you treated me. So it almost twisted everything. I'm like, oh, this is toxic masculinity. But in the way you're calling out toxic masculinity, you're bringing up, you're creating toxic femininity, which is crazy. And, you know, God forbid anybody says anything about that, but hey, whatever. What is it? Why is it that we gotta have us against them? Why don't you say, hey, listen, maybe I don't appreciate how XYZ is doing it, but for you to call everything that, you know, people in general enjoy pretty things. Well, when I say pretty things, good-looking things, you know, attractive people like, you know, again, that is a subjective thing when people find attractive, but for the most part, most people like attractive things. So you're going to tell me women don't objectify men too? Again, I'll bring this up, but I'll bring up another one too. We'll bring up Jason Momoa. All the ladies was loving Jason. Ladies was loving Henry Cavill as Superman. You know, I mean, Come on, you can't tell me it doesn't happen. And we can even go old school. Arnold Schwarzenegger. there are an idealized version of what people look like. And for those people who get to that level, why not? You know? And that's what they got hired for, the position they got hired for. is because they fit that description. And of course, with Alita, she is CGI. So it doesn't make sense for you to keep bringing it up, because that was how the character was designed. And of course, they like to bring up the point where, oh, she in her mind, that's how she thought that she should look. Yeah? Did you see the movie? Because in the movie, before, when they show her past, she had that same kind of body. Hello? Did you see the movie? But anyway, let's continue with this. But alas, Robert Rodriguez, directed by James Cameron's pet project, and instead of a complex, vibrant female character, Alita, Rosa Salazar, is reduced to a wide-eyed young woman. Literally, her CGI avatar, her eyes are huge, who feels more like a male fantasy than a woman's ideal of a hero. And that still piggybacks on what I was talking about earlier. Even if that is a guy's idea of what a female should like, that is also for women to enjoy too. For the woman to say, hey, look, that is a level that if I want to, I can get there. And I'm not, and again, it's not about pressuring people to have a certain body type. Listen, I'm not 110% fit either. I'm working on it, trying to get better at it, but I'm nowhere near where I was or where I need to be anyway. But I'm working on it. So should I say, oh, well, just because, somebody on TV looks a certain way, I have to look like that? No, I would like to get in better shape for me, and that's what I'm trying to do. And those people that you see on TV or whatever, or on a magazine, whatever, it's just a guideline. It's not for you to sit there and force yourself to be that way. If you can't do that, then you can't do that. If you can, more power to you. But it's not a requirement that you have to be that way. So, yeah, she may be idealized, but that's what most fictional characters are, as idealized versions of whatever that story is telling. But anyway, there's that. So we're going to hop into our next subject, because, you know, this thing with Alita actually is annoying me a lot, because I don't understand why we got to keep having this conversation that's basically bashing Alita when we can be boosting her up, you know, and hopefully getting some more butts in seats. But as everybody has been known, because this has been a hot topic for the whole day, for the last 24 hours, it's been a hot topic. Rotten Tomatoes has eliminated the want to see feature on their site, and from what everybody's saying is for Captain Marvel, which I am inclined to believe, because Captain Marvel, the last time I checked, had hit a whopping 27%, if I'm correct, it was about 27% of want to see. And now they have made it so that, if you look right here, it just has, you know, Captain Marvel, critics consensus, no consensus yet. Then it has tomato meter, NA, and it has audience score, NA. And then it has want to see is now only a want to see. It doesn't have a percentage of who doesn't want to see it. So you can't even check, you know, click down to see, oh, I don't want to see this movie. Which again, these were not reviews. This is people simply saying, hey, I don't want to see this movie. We've discussed this already, but there's what it is. My thing is, you guys aren't slick, because being that you did this like this, you know, all you've done is just made us have, first off, you made yourself look, you delegitimized yourself. I can't speak right now, sorry. You made yourself seem less reliable in the business that you're trying to do, which is to bring a form for your audience to be able to get engaged on a movie that they want to see. But by you doing this, all you've done is just made it so that now I'm still going to be able to calculate who doesn't want to see this movie, because if you went by something like, I don't know, Madea's movie, and I think that had like a 94 want to see, and you have, like for Captain Marvel, you have a 15,376 want to see. So you can still kind of gauge what people were trying to see. So if that number is low, like Madea's, which no knock on them, but hey, that's what it is. You can kind of see where it's at. So you're going to say that only out of the whole country, so out of your whole site, which you probably have millions of people on that site, I'm pretty sure you do. 15,000 people want to see it. So that's a minuscule number. So we can still see who does and who doesn't want to see, even though you're trying to, eliminate the whole, oh, people can go down there and you can actually see that it's dropping. Great. Nice try. I mean, aside from the fact that you make yourself look pretty dumb by doing this, whatever. I'm still going to say out of all the millions of people who are going to see this movie, only 15,000 want to see it. Well, you might as well just round it off, say 16,000. Just say round and say a nice 16,000 people want to see this movie. Ooh. I'm still going to bash it. I'm going to point and laugh because, hey, this only makes me feel some kind of way about what you're doing. But anyway, there's that. How do you guys feel about that? How do you feel about these subjects? I mean, Alita's still getting the whole treatment that it's getting, and then Captain Marvel with this treatment. So it's like you're pushing down one and trying to elevate the other. Again, I would rather be here, and I've said this several times now. I would rather be here to talk about how I'm hyped to see Captain Marvel and I love the leader, and let's go boost them both up. Why can't we be there? Why can't we be there? Oh, that's right. Because there's agenda based things going on right now. And we have agendas, like I said before, agendas don't equal good characters. And then you put a whole agenda around a whole project, you get this happening. So, how do you guys feel about that? The Rotten Tomatoes things, the Alita thing, let me know inside the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit that notification bell so you get my vids when I drop them. I catch y'all later. Peace. Seek peace and justice, efficient level. My planet is spotless on top of the game.